It's a big decision by the Narendra Modi government. The government has announced the appointment of a chief of defense staff. That's big. It was in the works for 20 years and finally Prakash Javadekar, union minister, announcing that it will be a four-star general. This four-star general will have the salary of an army, of an armed forces chief, and a separate department of military affairs is being created. The CDS will have the seniority of a secretary to government. I quickly want to bring in India Today's Anand Patel for more. Also with me is executive editor Sandeep Unnithan. But to you first, Anand, give us details of the appointment of a CDS.
Well, certainly it's a big, big decision, and this was in the offing for a long, long time. Gaurav, you've been reporting on this on several occasions, the need for it, and also the strategic importance of having a chief of defense staff, given the changed realities and changed geopolitics in the subcontinent. This becomes inevitable for the government to have a single point military advisor on strategic issues. Though we have a national security advisor, but the government from time to time has felt the need of having a military advisor in the form of chief defense staff. He'll be the senior most serving officer.
Stay with me for a moment. Let me quickly bring in Sandeep Unnithan. Sandeep, first amongst equals. We're still waiting for clarity on whether it would be one of the army commanders or it has to be one of the three chiefs. Is there clarity on that just as yet, Sandeep?
Well, Gaurav, we are given to understand that it's likely to be one of the three serving chiefs, given the fact that the CDS is the first among equals. And General Bipin Rawat's name is being mentioned simply for the reason that he is the chairman, chief of staff's committee. He is the candidate that's most likely to be the next CDS, given the virtue of his seniority.
So does this indicate that a new post is being created or one of the chiefs will be called the CDS?
Gaurav, it's a new post because, as you know already, the government has announced the new army chief, General Naravne. The chief of defense staff is going to be a completely new post with a new office, a new residence indeed, and he is going to function as the first among equals. He's going to be the single point advisor to the government on military affairs. And the most significant part of this announcement, Gaurav, is the fact that he will be the head of the Department of Military Affairs in the Defense Ministry, and he will have he will be equal to the post of secretary to the government of India, which means financial powers. This, I think, is the most significant aspect of this, because we've been questioning whether this is going to be just window dressing.
Yes.
It's just going to be an announcement for the sake of announcing a CDS. But the fact that the government has chosen to give him powers equal to the secretary of a government of India is very, very significant, given the fact that he would have financial powers. He'll have the powers to sign on files, he'll have financial teeth, he'll be able to sanction budgets, procurements, etc. That actually gives you a very, very clear indication into which way the government is thinking on the CDS, that it actually wants a CDS, an empowered CDS, as we're calling it.
An empowered chief of defense staff. Also with us is a consultant editor, Shiv Arur. Shiv, break this down for us. There's an army chief, a navy chief, an air chief, then a chief of defense staff. Now, what will be the role and task of the CDS as of now? What all do we know, Shiv?
Now, Gaurav, very interestingly, as announced and laid out, in the information that's been shared with us, is that this is much more than just a first among equals. Remember, this is not going to be a situation where there will be doubts over command and control. The four-star general who will be the chief of defense staff, will be above the four chiefs, will be a single point advisor to the government on all military affairs. And all of this, the armed forces and the chief of defense staff, will now fall under this newly created Department of Military Affairs.
Okay.
He will also be the permanent chairman of the Chiefs of Staff Committee. So it becomes a permanent position, without anything else, actually attached to it. There will be several secondary responsibilities as well. And I've just got some information, Gaurav, which I want to read out to our viewers about precisely what the remit of the Chief of Defense Staff is going to be. Will work exclusively pertaining to military matters, will fall within the purview of the Department of Military Affairs, while the Department of Defense will deal with the larger issues pertaining to the defense of the country. So that part is clear. The CDS will also have a secondary role, Gaurav. He will be the permanent chairman of the Chiefs of Staff Committee. In this role, he will be supported by the integrated defense staff. So what this basically means is there is not only the creation of the Chief of Defense Staff, but a restructuring of the command and control parameters of the existing defense organization chart, including by the integrated defense staff and the service headquarters, about where they will actually be reporting. So the CDS will administer the tri-services organization, will not exercise any military command, which is very important, will provide integrated inputs of the services to relevant authorities, and the CDS will be a member of the Defense Acquisition Council and Defense Planning Committees as well. So this is going to be, a sort of overall authority as far as jointness is concerned, provide long-term perspective and strategic planning is concerned, and bring out a sort of cohesive nature to the three armed forces while having a direct link with the Prime Minister's office. That's what this is all about, to actually optimize the armed forces, make them work together faster, better, stronger, and more, Gaurav. That's what the CDS is all
Gentlemen,
about.
Gentlemen, stay with me for a moment. We are getting a reaction from details from Prakash Javadekar. Let's quickly listen in.
In the country, the government has approved to create the post of Chief of Defense Staff in the rank of 4-star general with salary and perquisites equivalent to service chief, and the Chief of Defense Staff will also head the Department of Military Affairs to be created within the Ministry of Defense and function as its secretary. So we are giving you the full details.
So shortly we will have full details. Anand, when it comes to the work of the Chief of Defense Staff, the government is going to lay down what his charter of responsibilities will be at this press conference, we are told.
Yes, this is what the government has been planning for quite some time. This was in the talks in the power corridors for quite some time that a 4-star general is likely to be nominated as the Chief of Defense Staff. And this has been a long pending demand from the armed forces itself. You've been reporting on this, Gaurav, for a long time. The army has been demanding that there should be a single point command as far as these three services are concerned. So this is what the government has decided. And on top of it, if the government has also decided to give financial powers to the rank of secretary to the CDS, that will be a big boost to the defense services, and also it is likely to solve a lot of niggling issues related to the financial matters which the army or the navy or the air force have been raising from time to time. So big decision there from the government to appoint a CDS, and as we were discussing earlier, name of General Bipin Rawat is doing rounds. He's due to retire and likely to be nominated as the next or the first CDS,
Sandeep,
in fact.
The work, the charter of responsibilities, the CDS gives single point advice to the government but gets all information from the three service chiefs while he's first amongst equals, but he decides, or does he get to decide whether we're buying a tank first, an aircraft carrier first, a submarine first, or an aircraft first?
Absolutely, Gaurav. One of the priorities of the government in this case has been to optimize the budgets. As Shiv was mentioning, the fact is that the budget pie is more or less stable over the last couple of years, but the requirements of the armed forces are increasing, and the government has been telling the armed forces to rationalize their procurement lists. One of the very key roles that the CDS is going to do is to, as you mentioned, decide whether we need a tank first, we need a fighter aircraft first, or we need a warship first. So this is going to be one of his key roles and responsibilities. And given the fact that he has financial powers and he's the secretary as the head of the department, it very clearly means that the government is putting its money where its mouth is.
Okay. Now, are the three service chiefs, and what's extremely interesting at this point of time, the three service chiefs, they're senior to the defense secretary, the warrant of precedence. And will that be an issue if he's going to be a secretary to the government? Because secretary to a government means what? Where does he come in the warrant of precedence, Sandeep?
I think, Gaurav, from the looks of it, the three service chiefs, as you mentioned, are equal to the cabinet secretary. But the fact is that the CDS would also, by virtue of his perks and salaries, is going to be equal to the service chiefs. So while he will be equal to the cabinet secretary, he will discharge the roles and responsibilities of a secretary to the government of India.
So, which means that CDS would also be equivalent of a cabinet secretary?
Will be equivalent to the cabinet secretary, but he will discharge the roles and responsibilities of a secretary of the government of India, which means that he will more or less be equal to the defense secretary, who's the head of the defense ministry. So, you are actually creating another organization called the Department of Military Affairs. This will actually become clearer in the days ahead when we see the fine text of the government order about what the roles and responsibilities are precisely. But for now, it's very clear that the government has intended the CDS, the Chief of Defence Staff, to have financial powers and to head the Department of Military Affairs, which is being newly created.
While we wait for the government to list out details, let's quickly listen in to Major General G.D. Bakshi. We spoke to him a short while back.
Delighted. This was one of the most long overdue, desperately needed reforms of our defense, higher defense structure. The simple fact is you are a global power almost there, and I don't know how we have managed without a chief of defense staff for so long, and for petty bureaucratic reasons. When the Kargil Review Committee sat down after 1999, one of their primary recommendations was the compelling need for a chief of the defense staff. In today's day and age, synergy is the way to go. Tri-service integration is the way to go. You can't survive without it.
This is a very significant step taken by the Narendra Modi government. For 20 years, Kargil Review Committee said for better integration of the armed forces and for optimum utilization of the armed forces in times of combat, we need a chief of defense staff, single point advisor to the government. That is finally happening 20 years later. 1999 it was recommended, 2019 it is finally happening. We'll get you more on that story. A quick break.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.